Hi everyone, this is lecture 27 in analog circuits. In this lecture, I will give some introduction to operational amplifier or simply op-amp. In this, we will discuss about these topics, that is internal block diagram of operational amplifier, then pin diagram of IC741 op-amp, then we will see what are the ideal characteristics of operational amplifier, and finally we will see what are the applications of operational amplifier. Before that, first we will see what is the weightage of this operational amplifier in the gate exam. In gate 2016, set 1 we got 6 marks from the operational amplifier, in set 2 5 marks, set 3 2 marks. In gate 2017, from set 1 3 marks, set 2 2 marks. That is, from the operational amplifier or the applications of this operational amplifier or different circuits using op-amp, we will get 2 marks to 6 marks maximum. So average we can say 3 marks, sometimes 4 marks, etc. So this is about the marks wise analysis for this operational amplifiers in the gate exam. Remember, the questions will be very simple if you know the basics of this operational amplifier, that too virtual ground concept, right? So you can easily score from this operational amplifier concept in the gate exam. Rarely we'll get the tough question from the operational amplifier. Now we will discuss about these topics one by one. Now first we will see what is the internal block diagram of operational amplifier. So in the internal structure of op-amp, we will have mainly 4 blocks. The first block is always differential amplifier. So differential amplifier is the first block, right? So it will have 2 inputs, so I'm giving the names as V1 and V2, and the second stage will have different names. Some textbooks you will see intermediate stage, some textbooks you will see second stage gain, some textbooks you will see differential amplifier 2, etc. So that second stage I'm giving as second stage gain. Why I'm giving the name as second stage gain is, so this stage is used for only giving more gain or more amplification purpose, right? And the next block is, this name is called, block is called level shifter, right? And the final block is, so again it will have the different names. Sometimes you will see voltage buffer, sometimes you will see unity follower, sometimes you will see power amplifier. So I am giving as voltage follower or voltage buffer, right? And finally we can give it to the load. So mainly these 4 are the internal blocks of operational amplifier: differential amplifier, second stage gain, level shifter, and voltage follower, right? So this will be given to a load. So if we connect all these circuits, then it will become operational amplifier. Now we'll discuss what each block is doing. The first block is differential amplifier. So what it should do? The first one is simply differential or simply diff amplifier. So the differential amplifier will amplify only the differential signals. If we give the same voltage, that is V1 is equal to V2, output will be 0. So when we give different signals, suppose V1 is equal to 1, V2 is equal to -1, then it will amplify. When you give same voltage, it will not amplify. So that is the main aim of the differential amplifier. Now you will ask why. See, amplifier means what? So it should strengthen the weak signals. Yes or no? So generally when you see public addressing systems or any amplifier, so we will give a very small signal, weak signal to any amplifier, we will get a amplified version, right? So the strength will be improved. Now If you use, suppose, single stage amplifier, not a differential amplifier, simply amplifier. So what are the disadvantage of this simple amplifier is, suppose for amplification we have to supply a supply voltage. So generally if it is a BJT, we will ask VCC. So what the problem occurs is, suppose if any supply fluctuations comes, so actually should be suppose 10 volts, but due to supply fluctuations, so it may change. So this may affect the output of the operation, I mean amplifier. So you may get some distortions in the output. So that is the one disadvantage when you use simple single stage amplifier, simply amplifier. Similarly, that suppose there are so much noise in the environment. So if that noise is added to the input signal, so this may affect the output also again, right? So due to noise, the output will be disturbed, and due to this supply fluctuations, the output will be disturbed. So these disadvantages will be overcome when we use differential amplifier. How? So it will have two voltages, V1 and V2, and this is a differential amplifier. So we may take differential output, we may take single ended output also, right? Now, so what this differential amplifier will do is, it will amplify the difference. Suppose it is V0, so there is a gain into V1 minus V2, that is a differential voltage. Suppose it is a signal like this, so V1 is like this, means V2 should be opposite. If there is a same, suppose something like this, we will get output as 0. So that means it will not amplify the same signal. Means the differential amplifier will not amplify the same signals, right? Suppose if we apply V1 like this and V2 opposite, that is generally we say 180 degree phase shift, then V0 will be something, that is V1 minus V2. So now it is finite value. So that means it will happen. So what is V1 minus V2? We will get, suppose this is 1 milli. So opposite means minus 1 milli. So 1 milli minus of minus 1 milli. So we will get 2 milli as maximum peak and minus 2 milli as the minimum peak. So it will be amplified. Suppose gain is 100. So we will get peak to peak. Suppose 4 millivolts. So 4 milli. So that means how much? 400 millivolts peak to peak is the output signal, or we can say 0.4 volts. Now, so what is the advantage? So where is the advantage? So generally, whenever noise is added, it is like a common signal. So noise will be added here. The same noise will be added here also. Now, if I take the difference between these two signals, I will get a clean signal, something like this. Because see this. See, it is increasing, it is also increasing, but when I take the difference, the noise effect will become zero. Why? See here, it is increasing. Suppose it is 0.01 millivolts. So this is also 0.01 millivolts. So 0.01 milli minus 0.01 milli. So we'll get zero. So we'll get the clean signal, right? So V0 is equal to 100 into this clean signal. So that is the main advantage of this differential amplifier. So it will reject the common mode noise, right? So whenever noise is added, it will add common. So whatever the noise is added here, same noise will be added here. So that's why we'll use the differential amplifier as the first stage of operational amplifier. Now, how it is rejecting the supply variations? Very simple. Suppose we have only single supply, right? So VCC, right? Or VSAT or something plus V, minus V, etc. Suppose this noise is added. For that, I will take the differential output, right? Suppose V0 is there. So we got something like this. So due to this power supply variations, I got this noise effect here. Suppose if I take one more output, V02, which is opposite, something like this. So due to this power supply variations, I will get that noise will be added here. Now if I take this V0 as the differential output, V01 minus V02, again I will get the clean output waveform, right? So that is also one more advantage. So if I take the differential output, so it will reject the supply fluctuations. So these two advantages makes the differential amplifier very useful block in the operational amplifier. So that is the operation of this differential amplifier. So it will amplify only the differential signals. It will reject the common mode signals. Now, why we need this second stage gain? Remember, when we are going for amplification purpose, so how much amplification we require, right? So that depends on the where we are using the that amplifier. Suppose if the input signal is suppose in microvolts range, right? So whenever there is a input voltage in the microvolts range, we need very high amplification, right? So approximately 10 to the power 6, right, or 10 to the power 5 range. But if I use only single stage, maximum it gave suppose 100 or up to 1000. So we need one more gain stage to get approximately 10 to the power 5 or 10 to the power 6 and so on. Suppose if I want 10 to the power 5, so first stage I will go for 100, second stage I will go for 1000. So if I make 1000 gain, second stage gain, so 1000 into 100, I will get 1 lakh gain. That is total is 10 to the power 5. Suppose first stage is giving only 100, I have to make the second stage gain as 1000. If I want 10 to the power 6, so the first stage is 1000, second stage also 1000. So that's why we are going for the second stage gain. I hope it is clear. Then there is a level shifter. What this level shifter will do is, see, whenever we are doing the amplification, suppose if I give only the signal, generally we give AC signals, right? Suppose this is the input. So assume that this is a differential signal VD. So once we amplify, so if we see the internal circuit diagram of differential amplifier, we will see either MOSFETs or BJTs. So when we do biasing, so when we see, suppose this is V01, so this is actually ground level will be there, but after differential amplifier first stage, so that may jump to some DC level, suppose maybe some voltage, something like this, so amplified version, right? After the second stage gain, so the DC level will be shifted, right? So when we want to give this to the final stage, so there is a DC level, right? If we give directly this waveform to this voltage follower, right, the bias point of this voltage follower may change, so it may not work as voltage follower, it may work as simply switch on and off, etc. So we have to bring back this DC level to ground level, right? So for that I will use a level shifter. This level shifter is nothing but a clamper. If you recall, when we discussed the clamper circuit, clamper either it will add the DC level or it may restore the DC level. So it can bring back to the DC as zero. So that is a level shifter. So why we need level shifter? So to restore the DC level which is present in the output waveform after the second stage before giving to the final stage of the operational amplifier. I can give this explanation in different way also. So generally if we go inside of this blocks differential amplifier, we will see the BJTs or MOSFETs. So differential amplifier means you will see something like this V1. So there is some R1 or R2. If I use only active loads, you will see again only transistors. So when we discuss the differential amplifier in detail, there we can discuss about this transistor and differential amplifier, etc. But see what is happening inside this differential amplifier. So when we use V1 and V2, when we bias this transistors Q1 and Q2, so when we give some AC signal, it will amplify. But if you see, this is the collector. So collector voltage is there for proper operation. This should be in active region. For active region, there should be some sufficient voltages. So when it is amplified, the voltage, this VC, upon this VC will have the AC signal, which is amplified version. Now generally if you see multi-stage amplifiers, we will see the coupling capacitors between stage 1 and stage 2. What this coupling capacitor will do is, it will block the DC, that is whatever the DC is there, that will be stored here, and only this AC signal will go. And if I give to one more transistor, so we are not giving any DC voltage. So whatever the operating point, suppose this is 0.7 volt, that will be fixed. Suppose what happens if there is no coupling capacitor here? So whatever the DC voltage is directly connected to the base of the next state. So actually it should be 0.7. Due to this VC is directly connected to this VB, so the operating point may change. So actually it is an active region. Due to this DC voltage applied directly, it may go to saturation region. Once it is entering into saturation region, it will not do amplification. So what we need to do, we have to bring back this DC component to ground level, right? So for that reason, we will use level shifter, right? Now I hope it is clear. So why we are using this level shifter? So to bring back the DC level to ground level. Now the final stage is called voltage follower. The other names are there. This is also called power amplifier, right? Or voltage buffer, etc. So why we require this voltage follower here? So this we need to discuss in detail. Suppose there is a weak signal after the first stage, then second stage, and after the level shifter, we got the DC component as 0, and there is a AC component which is amplified version of the input. Now can we apply directly this waveform or this signal to the load, or we in a public addressing system, the last load is loudspeaker, yes or no? And if you know, what is the loudspeaker impedance? The impedance of the loudspeaker is very small, maybe 10 ohms, right? Maximum 10 ohms, 8 to 10 ohms. Now if you see this level shifter or whatever, the impedance of this level shifter will be very high. So generally we use here again a amplifier or something. So the impedance of this stage, or we can say second stage, output impedance will be very large. Now if we give directly output of this stage to loudspeaker, it will not deliver the maximum power to the load, right? So when it is not delivering the maximum power to the load, it may not give the enough sound, right? So there should be some device which should match the impedance. Now why we need to match this impedance? If you recall the maximum power transfer theorem, so suppose this is the source and it is having source resistance RS. Suppose there is a load which is RL generally. So this source will give maximum power to the load when RS is equal to RL. So that is a maximum power transfer theorem. Now to satisfy that maximum power transfer theorem, I have to use one more block which is called power amplifier. And here you should remember one thing: power amplifier will not amplify the power, it will transfer maximum power to the load. Always remember, it will not give any voltage gain, right? Why? Voltage follower means, or voltage buffer means, whatever the input voltage, that will be same at the output. Now for this power amplifier or voltage follower, the input impedance will be very large, and the output impedance is small. So small in the sense, in this range only, 10 ohms, 100 ohms, in that range, right? If these two impedance are matched, so it will deliver maximum power to the load. So that work is done by this power amplifier or voltage follower or voltage buffer, etc. So what this fellow is doing, it is only matching the impedance of the load and the output of the third stage, or generally we say second stage, right? That's why we don't require any gain at the before the load. That's why it is voltage follower, means output follows the input. So what are the changes here? We will get the same changes. So that will be given to the load, so that it will deliver the maximum power to the load. So you will get the maximum sound, right? So what we need to remember, power amplifier will not amplify the power, it will deliver maximum power to the load by matching the impedances. So I hope it is clear what each block is doing. Again I am repeating, the differential amplifier will amplify the differential signals, it will reject the common mode signals or common mode noise. and the second stage is for only for gain purpose to get the maximum gain. And the third one is level shifter. It will restore the DC component which is present in the output of the second stage. And the voltage follower or power amplifier will deliver the maximum power to the load by making impedance matching, right? So this is about the internal block diagram of the operational amplifier. When we connect all these blocks, so that circuit is called operational amplifier. And when I talk about the internal circuit diagram of all these blocks, so generally in a single operational amplifier circuit, we will see approximately 16 either BJTs or MOSFET. Generally when we are manufacturing the IC, we will use the MOSFETs. So approximately 16 MOSFETs and one resistor, maybe one capacitor which is very small. So when we connect these 16 plus 1 plus 1, 18 components, it will become as a operational amplifier, right? And it will give some advantages to the amplification purpose. See, when we are talking about any device, suppose if it is an amplifier, if it is a filter or any circuit, it should have some ideal characteristics. So ideally we can say, suppose ideal gain is infinity. So generally when we design in a single stage amplifier like RC coupled or CE amplifier or a common source amplifier, the gain will be like 100, maximum 200 or maybe 300, maximum 1000. But when I need very high 10 to the power 6 or 10 to the power 5 and so on, so we need a device or a circuit which will provide that much gain. So that will be given by the operation amplifier. Now how this operation amplifier is giving that much gain, like 10 to the power 5 or 10 to the power 6, because of these many number of stages are there inside the operation amplifier. So when we connect all these blocks, so we will get very high gain, like 10 to the power 5 or 1 lakh to 10 lakhs gain, and other characteristics also. Anyway, that we are going to see now. But before that, we have to see the pin diagram of operation amplifier. Now, before that, we should understand two terms. And before that, we should understand some two names, that is discrete circuit, integrated circuit. I think most of you know, but I will explain once again. So what is the discrete circuit means? If we connect a discrete components on a breadboard or printed circuit board, so discrete components means all will be visible. Suppose something like this. If we take the CE amplifier, this is RC, R1, R2, RE, there is a bypass capacitor, coupling capacitor, and one more coupling capacitor, etc. And this is some VCC, and I have to apply, here, VI, and all these are connected to ground. So when we connect these components in a printed circuit board or simply breadboard, so that circuit is called discrete circuit, because every component will be visible for us, right? Whereas in integrated circuit, all the components are manufactured in a single silicon wafer. So when we design this and when we give it to the any manufacturing company, what they will provide us is a simple sum, a box, so given as some IC which will give some serial number, etc. And they will give only output pins and input pins or something. The pin diagram will be there. So what is the each pin is providing, etc. So we will not see any component, where is the transistor, where is the resistor, or where is the capacitor, right? Anyway, we don't use any resistors, capacitors when we manufacturing the integrated circuit. Remember, every component will be manufactured using the transistor. So resistor can be designed using MOSFET. Capacitor can be designed or implemented using MOSFET, etc. So in integrated circuit, only we will see the transistor, especially MOSFETs. So now when we see the internal block diagram of this operational amplifier, we are seeing this so many stages, and I told you it will consist of 16 MOSFETs, one resistor, one capacitor. So when we interconnect all these transistors in a single wafer, so we will see only the pin diagram. So the first IC, the operational amplifier, is IC means integrated circuit. The serial number is 741. I think everyone heard about this IC number, IC 74. op amp, right? So integrated circuit means, I told you, we will have only the pins which will be given, and there is some notation will be there to identify which one is 1 and which one is 8. So this IC741 will have total 8 pins, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So 5, 6, 7, 8. So you will see some IC741, right? Now, what is this first pin name is? It is called offset null, right? I tell you what is this offset null. Second one is inverting terminal, right? Third one is non-inverting terminal, or we can say this is minus and this is the plus terminal. And the fourth pin is negative supply, that is minus V. And again, fifth one is offset null. Sixth one is output. Seventh one is positive supply. Eighth pin is, generally we don't connect anything, so not connected. You'll see is simply NC, right? So this is the pin configuration of the operation amplifier, which is, what is the IC number? 741, right? So generally in our labs we will see this IC741 when we are doing any lab experiment. Now, what is this offset null means? So generally, if we take any amplifier, when we don't give any input, no input, that means we should not get any outputs, that means no output. So generally we may get some output, that is called output offset. If we are giving zero input, so suppose VI equal to zero, but suppose V naught is, we are getting some 5 millivolts or maybe 0.05 millivolt. So this is called generally offset voltage. So to make this offset voltage, we have to give some input voltage by or through these offset points, right? So to nullify the output offset voltage, we have to provide some input, right? So that will be provided or given to this through this pins 1 and 5, right? So that is this offset null means. I think everyone may have seen the weighing machine. Yes or no? When I want to operate any weighing machine, initially it should show zero reading. Yes or no? Suppose it is showing some 0.01 kg etc. or something. So that is not a proper weighing machine. So what we will do is, we will adjust this machine to read as zero initially. So there should be some pins or knobs to adjust, and it should show zero, right? And if you go to any vegetable market, so generally before weighing anything, so first they will see the weight is equal or not. Yes or no? If it is not equal, they put some weight, right? So initially it should show like this. Suppose it is showing like this, so they will put some weight to make equal. So that is called offset null. So we have to make the offset as nullified. We have to make that it should show initially zero, then we can operate. So that is this offset null points, right? And there's an inverting and non-inverting means. So generally for operation amplifier, there will be two inputs, right? V1 and V2. So V1 will be given to negative terminal, V2 will be given to positive terminal, etc. And there will be two supplies and one output terminal. Now, when I want to use this operation amplifier in different circuits, so I cannot use always this pin diagram. So we have to use a symbol. So I think everyone sees this symbol. The operation amplifier symbol is like a something like this, triangular. So there is a minus and plus. So minus is inverting terminal, plus is non-inverting terminal. So what is the numbers of this? The inverting terminal is 2, non-inverting terminal is 3. So I can give like this is V1, this is V2, or this is V2 or this is V1, doesn't matter. And it will have an output, so I can give as V0. And what is the terminal number? This is 6, right? So these 3 are enough. But if I want to use, I can use the 2 power supplies, that is V plus and V minus. So what is V minus? This is the fourth terminal and this is the seventh terminal. So when I want to use this as a symbol in a different circuits, so sometimes we will use this V plus V minus. So more frequently we will use 2 and 3 and 6. So generally we don't give the names also. So simply we can use like this, minus plus, like this. So this is V naught, this is V1 and V2. So simply remember this symbol for op amp or operational amplifier. Now we will see what are the ideal characteristics of this operational amplifier. Now amplifier means, so any amplifier or any thing in the world should have some ideal characteristics, right? So when we design, we have to think that we have to achieve that ideal characteristics. So what are those characteristics are? When you are talking about the amplifier, the first thing should be gain. So this ideal gain or ideal voltage gain should be very large. So ideally means infinity, but practically this will be 10 to the power 5 to 10 to the power 6 for operation amplifier. When we go practically, it will give this much gain, 1 lakh to 10 lakhs. And the second one is bandwidth. Bandwidth. So ideally it is also infinity, but practically it will give one maximum up to 1 megahertz. Now, what is this bandwidth? So when we are talking about the amplifier, bandwidth means with respect to omega or with respect to F also. The range of frequencies where the gain is constant. Suppose if I see the frequency response, later we will see the frequency response of operation amplifier. So this is the maximum gain, suppose A naught, and this is some F3 dB or omega 3 dB, and there is a unity gain frequency also FT, right? So generally we will talk about the bandwidth means 3 dB bandwidth. So this 3 dB bandwidth should be very large. What is the reason is, see, amplification means, see, if zero frequency signal comes, it should amplify. 1 kilohertz frequency comes, it should amplify. 2 kilohertz, 3 kilohertz, 10 kilohertz, 100 megahertz, or whatever the frequency is coming, it should amplify. Yes or no? If I am speaking, I am generating one frequency Y signal. Other fellow is speaking, so he may generate different frequency signal. So whatever the frequency is coming, the amplification should be in the same. So suppose 10 to the power 6 is the gain, 1 hertz frequency signal is coming, I should get same gain. Next, suppose 1 kilohertz signal frequency is coming, so it should get the same amplification, right? And 10 kilohertz, same amplification. But suppose 20 kilohertz, I am getting only 10 to the power 10 square, right? That means the bandwidth is small. Up to 10 kilohertz only, it is giving the maximum gain. After that, it may not give the maximum gain. So that is the bandwidth, right? So if the bandwidth is very large, so it will amplify all the frequencies in between them, right? So ideally speaking, it should be infinity, but when we design, we will get maximum is 1 megahertz, that is 10 to the power 6 hertz, right? So gain ideally infinity, but practically this much. Bandwidth ideally infinity, practically this much. So this is about the two characteristics. One more is the input impedance. So ideally speaking, input should be infinity. I'll tell you the reason also. And output impedance, ideally speaking, it should be zero. Reasons I'll tell you later. Next term or characteristic is, it is called CMRR, that is called common mode rejection ratio. So this is a parameter which tells us that how effectively operation amplifier rejecting the common mode signals or common mode noise. So it should be ideally speaking infinity, right? And practically it is, again, it is the range of 10 to the power 5 to 10 to the power 6. Like if I take dBs, 100 dB to 120 dBs. So this is also 10 to the power 5 means 100 dB to 120 dB, maybe 200 dB also sometimes we will get. So common mode rejection ratio should be ideally infinity. And there are other parameters like power supply, rejection ratio, etc. So I will not talk about that. CMRR, then slew rate. So this is also ideally speaking infinity. So generally we'll see 10 volt per microsecond or maybe 2 volt per microsecond. That is the maximum rate of change of output voltage, that is dv naught by dt. Anyway, we'll discuss about the slew rate later. So dv naught by dt maximum should be ideally infinity. That is within seconds I should get the output. How much fast the operation amplifier is changing the, so suppose if I give 1 microvolt as the input, so how much fast it is converting into 1 volt. So if the slew rate is suppose 2 volt per microsecond, that is the meaning is micro means 10 to the power 6, so 2 into 10 to the power 6 per second. So this much amount of voltage is changing per second, right? So ideally it should be very large, but practically we'll get these ranges, 10 to the power 10 volt per microsecond or 2 volt per microsecond, right? So these are the ideal characteristics of operational amplifier. I forgot to give the practical values of this input impedance. So generally it is greater than 100 kilo ohms, and this output impedance is maximum 100 ohms. So generally it will be less than 100 ohms. This is greater than 100 kilo ohms. Now, how can we say that the input impedance of any amplifier should be infinity, output impedance is zero? So for that, I need to draw the model of this amplifier. So suppose operation amplifier, and when we consider this is like a voltage amplifier, right? So voltage amplifier means input voltage, output is also voltage. So from the symbol, I can draw the model. So this is V1, V2, and this is V0, and it is having gain as A, which is 10 to the power 5 to 10 to the power 6. Now when I draw the internal model of this operational amplifier, or we can say small signal model of this operational amplifier, so it will have the input impedance which will provide VI, right? And the amplification should be there, that is in terms of A into VI. So ideally speaking, if I give VI, I should get V0 is equal to A into VI. But practically, there will be a series resistance which is R0. Then we will get V0 here, and this is VI. But when I go again practically, so if I take any AC source plus minus, which is having like a VS, and it will have some any practical voltage source will have the contains some internal resistance RS. So this is, and it will have may have some load RL, right? So this is the actual model for any voltage amplifier. Now how can we say that RI should be infinity, R0 should be zero? So for that I'm giving some explanation, so please follow carefully. Now remember, so this is coming from any source, suppose mic, so which is converted into some electrical signal which is having a signal strength like this. So maybe I'm having suppose 1 microvolts, right? Now the operational amplifier which will have the model like this, RI A into VA R0. So this is the practical purpose when I give some input voltage like this. Now will it amplify? Remember, I want to give this voltage signal as the input of the operation amplifier, but there is a series resistance here. We cannot avoid this resistance. It will be very small, maybe 10 ohms or 20 ohms, 100 ohms, whatever. I cannot avoid this RS, but I have to give this signal as the input of the operation amplifier. Now, how can I make VS is equal to VS or VI is equal to VS? Now without any loss of this, I should provide to the amplifier input. I cannot make this as zero. This is the internal resistance of this practical voltage source. Now what is the other option to make VI is equal to VS? Suppose if I make the current suppose zero, if the current is zero, what is the drop across this RS? Will be zero. So whenever there is no drop across the RS, so what will be the VI? Now we can apply KVL here. So minus Vs plus 0 plus Vi is equal to 0. That means Vi is equal to Vs. Now, why we need like this? So, very simple. Suppose Vs is equal to 1 microvolt and gain is equal to 10 to the power 6. That means what is V0? 10 to the power 6 into 1 microvolt I should get. So, 10 to the power 6 into 1 micro means I will get 1 volt. Now, suppose Ri is equal to 10 ohms, Rs is equal to 10 ohms. So, that means I cannot be 0. Now, if I apply this KVL or voltage division rule, Vi is equal to Vs into Ri by Rs plus Ri. So, both are equal means, so Vs into 1 by 2. So, Vi is becoming Vs by 2. So, we will get 0.5 microvolts if Vs is equal to 1 microvolt. Then, what will be V0 now? 10 to the power 6 into 0.5 microvolts. So, what I will get? 0.5 volts only. See this, the output voltage signal is reduced by 2 times or 50% is reduced. So, that should not happen. For that reason, I cannot make Rs as 0. But what is the other option? So, to make current 0, I have to make this Ri as infinity. So, when it is infinity, it will be like a open circuit. So, whenever it is open circuit, no current flows. So, Vi will be equal to Vs. So, that's why whenever there is a voltage amplifier, always the input impedance or input resistance should be infinity. Why? This is the reason. So, there should not be any drop across this Rs. So, we need to make this Ri as high as possible. Right? That's why if I take this is as a 100 kilo ohm, so almost there is a negligible drop across the Rs. So, that is the about the input impedance. Now, output impedance, that is R0. See, I cannot make RL as infinity or 0 because there is RL means load resistance. So, load resistance should be always finite. So, generally it will be very small because for audio amplifiers, we will use load speaker as a load. So, RL will be like a 8 ohms, 10 ohms, etc. Now, why R0 should be 0? For that, now, if you recall, what is V0 should be equal to A into Vi. So, that means the gain will be V0 by Vi. Now, if we see this, suppose if this is R0 is finite value. So, suppose make it as 10 kilo ohms. And this is a V0. So, what will be V0? Apply KVL across this loop. So, minus A into Vi plus some IL into R0 plus V0 is equal to 0. See here, minus A into Vi. So, if this current is going like this, so plus minus IL into R0 plus V0. So, what is V0? V0 is equal to A into Vi minus IL into R0. Now, see, actually, ideally speaking, V0 should be equal to A into Vi, but there is a drop which is IL into R0. So, I need V0 is equal to A into Vi. So, what is the possible conditions? I have to make R0 is equal to 0 so that the drop across the R0 will be 0 so that V0 will be A into Vi. So, that is the reason why we will make the output impedance is very low means ideally speaking 0. Because there should not be any drop. So, I have to make V0 is equal to A into Vi. So, there should not be any loss in the gain. Right? For that, the output impedance should be 0 and input impedance should be infinity. So, these are the two reasons. For voltage amplifier, output resistance should be ideally 0. Practically very small. Input impedance should be very large. Ideally speaking, infinity. So, these are two reasons why the input impedance infinity, output impedance 0. I hope it is clear. If you are having error, please post a comment. Now, finally, we see what are the applications of operation amplifier. The first application is, we will use this operation amplifier to amplify AC as well as DC signals. So, remember, the op amp, it will amplify the or strengthen the AC signals as well as DC signals also. I have shown you the frequency response of the operation amplifier. So, this is gain versus frequency or omega or F. So, zero frequency also will get the gain. We will discuss the frequency response maybe later. But you can remember operation amplifier will amplify the DC also, but the normal RC coupled CE amplifier or any common source etc, they will not amplify the DC signals, they will amplify only AC signals, but operation amplifier will amplify the DC signals also. And it will be used in for different mathematical operations like integration. So these are the some applications we are going to discuss. So we may get questions from the those applications also, like differentiation. And if we add some diode, we can go you can do the logarithmic, anti-log, etc. Then we can do adder or summer, right? Then subtractor, right? Addition, subtraction, multiplication, etc. So many mathematical operations we can do using operation amplifier. So that's why it is called operational amplifier. So actually it is an amplifier, but it can do lot of mathematical operations. So that's why it is called operational amplifier, right? So what are those operations, like integration, differentiation, logarithmic, adding, subtraction, etc., right? So that's why the name comes as operation amplifier. Remember, whenever you see any communication, any subject, when you see a device, mostly it will be amplifier. It can do so many operations, so that we can use this amplifier, especially operation amplifier, in so many different subjects or so many different circuits, right? It may be communication purpose, it may be electronic purpose, it may be another purpose also. You will see one circuit everywhere that is called amplifier, right? And we can use this operation amplifier in the designing of filters, comparators, which will compare two inputs, and pulse shaping circuits. Like it can be used in the waveform generators, like a square waveform generator, triangular waveform generator, sawtooth waveforms, etc. And we can use to generate sinusoidal signals, which are oscillators and other circuits, etc., right? So these are the some applications of the operational amplifier. So I hope it is clear about all these topics. If you are having any doubt, please post a comment.